Hello everyone. I welcome you all to Grade Up. I hope I'm audible and visible to all of you. I welcome you all to this series on George Summer's Puzzles that we are doing currently. I'm Saral with you today with the second session on this series. So just confirm once, guys, am I clearly audible to you? And I again wish a very good evening to all of you. I hope you are keeping safe in these COVID times nowadays. I mean, everything is so dicey, so it is extremely important for us to keep ourselves safe. So please confirm, guys, just once that is everything all right? Am I audible and visible to all of you? And then we'll start doing this second session, which is on George J. Summer's puzzle that we are doing. I think I have talked to you about this in the previous class as well, that this is a session basically which is important to improve our logical reasoning. So of course it will be important for all the people who are appearing for these management exams or of any other exam. Let us say you are appearing for any other banking exam, SSC exam, UPSC exam or any other exam. Most of the times you will feel that, you will see that in these exams you have questions which are based upon puzzles and all, LR and all. तो यहाँ पे हम लोग उसी एल आर के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं. एंड वेन वी डू दीज पजल्स, ऑफ कोर्स आर रीजनिंग वुड बी इम्प्रूव, विच इज द बेसिक पर्पज ऑफ डूइंग दीज थिंग्स. ओके, हाय, हेलो आदित्य मित्रा, हाय ऋषि चुग, ओके, ऑडिबल एंड विजिबल, ग्रेट, थैंक यू. सो दिस इज द सेकेंड सेशन इन दिस सीरीज. एवरी टाइम वी आर टेकिंग 3-4 पजल्स. सम ऑफ देम आर स्लाइटली मोर डिफिकल्ट देन दी अदर्स. तो कई बार हम लोग 3 से पजल्स करेंगे, कभी कभार 4 पजल्स भी कर लिया करेंगे. सो दिस विल बी द ऑर्डर थ्रू विच विल बी डूइंग इट. But yes, one good thing is that whatever we are doing, it is extremely important to improve the reasoning. Plus, it has never been done before in YouTube. Okay? This is the first time that we have such things on YouTube where we are discussing these puzzles. No one has done those before. So therefore, it becomes more important for us to understand this well. Okay? Kiska importance kya ho jata hai? Let us start talking about, first of all, Grade Up. So whatever you are seeing right now, or me as well, this is all on Grade Up channel that we are talking about, right? Which is India's number one trusted app as far as when I talk about the educational industry in that. So probably this is the number one company that we have currently, right? Which is trusted by, of course, 3 crore plus students. And here I'm talking about for exam preparation of different types, whether it is management exams or the government exams or whichever exams, teaching, etc., whatever is there. So Grade Up is into all those domains, though currently we are focusing upon MBA entrance examinations, because the level of the questions would be slightly on the difficult side, right? Which is generally there in CAT, Z type of exams. But yes, as I told you, reasoning hai, improve hogi to kahin bhi kaam aayegi, bahut jagah pe kaam aayegi. And currently, because everyone is sitting at home because of these COVID situations, so ghar se tayari mein hi samajhdari is something that we are running right now, through which we are giving 55% off for any of these super subscriptions that you take for CAT, MAT, CET, CMAT or other exams. So you have to use this code to avail this discount if any one of you is planning to register in Grade Up. And why should you join that? That is all written on this screen that you can easily see over here. The live courses, expert faculties, best practice and study material, and this all would be available once you join Grade Up, right? So that's all about Grade Up, guys. So let's move on to the important part of today's session, the fourth puzzle. In the last class we did the first three puzzles of George J. Summer's. I'll be doing them in exactly the same order, right, the way they are given in the book. So even the names of the puzzles I have kept the same, so that you can always find out on the, in the book whenever you require. Kyunki kai baar hum log ye puzzle discuss karenge, uske baad bhi if you try them, still you might find them a bit difficult. कि कई बार हो सकता है तब भी ना हो रही हूं, ठीक है? So definitely try them at home. जब तक आप खुद नहीं कर लेंगे तब तक आपको confidence आएगा भी नहीं. So even if you do them here, I would always suggest, यहां से करने के बाद भी कोशिश किया कीजिए, घर से जाके जरूर करें, ठीक है? Hi, good evening प्रीतम गोस्वामी. So I think we can move on to this. Hi रोहित शर्मा, good evening, you're great. Okay, thank you very much रोहित शर्मा. So here is the first puzzle of the day, that is puzzle number 4 from the book, and the name that they have given is The Woman Freeman Will Marry. So this is the information given to us. Let us read this information together and then we'll start solving it. Theek hai, fir uske sath sath usko karna bhi shuru karenge. The information is, Freeman knows five women, A, B, C, D, and E. These are the five women. The women are in two age brackets. Three women are under 30 and two women are over 30. Two of them are teachers and the other three are secretaries. A and C are in the same age bracket. D and E are in this different age bracket. B and E have the same occupation. C and D have different occupations. Of the five women, Freeman will marry the teacher over 30. So who will Freeman marry? Good evening, Madhurima. So this is exactly those kind of questions that are appearing in these LRDI exams and all. So anyone who feels I'm not good at LRDI, trust me, do this book completely and you will get to know that how to improve LRDI. Because there are all kinds of questions and the type of questions, the variety of questions which is there in this book, this is definitely going to make you too good at LRDI. At least you would not be afraid of these different kind of sets that appear in LRDI. Unse aapka dar bilkul khatm ho jayega. Theek hai? Chaliye ji, iske bare mein shuruaat karte hain. Hum log kaise karna hai? It says the women are in two age brackets. Three women are under 30 and two women are above 30. So if this is 30 years of age, I would say there are three ladies below 30 and there are two ladies above 30. There are three women who are below 30 and there are two women above 30. This is my way of representing. You might have a different way of representing. Just look at that. Ki aapko kaun sa pasand hai, aap us pe dhyan dijiyega. Theek hai? Two women are teachers and the other three are secretaries. So there are two teachers here and there are three secretaries here. So there are three people below 30, two people above 30, three secretaries and two teachers. This is the complete info. Next, A and C are in the same age bracket. So that means here I can write it like this, ki A and C in a box. Matlab ye mera represent karne ka tarika hai. Box banane ka matlab ye, they would be together, right? They would together be here, that is above 30, or they would together be here, that is below 30. Both possibilities can exist. D and E are in the different age brackets. So that I write like this. D and E are in the different age brackets. Box mein bana diya, that means they would be together. Aur aisa bana diya arrow, iska matlab they would be in different age brackets. Now here the important point is, matlab jitna aap zyada conclude kar sake statement se utna behtar rehta hai. LRDI ka basically purpose ye hota hai. So A and C, if I together put them here, let's say, for a moment, let us assume कि A और C को मैंने दोनों को यहां रख दिया. So can I see all the other three ladies B, D and E, they all would be below 30 and this condition would go wrong. D and E, they should be on the opposite sides of 30. तो अगर D और E में से एक इधर है और एक इधर है, how can A and C both come on this side? वो तो possible ही नहीं रहा फिर ऐसे केस में. And therefore by this logic I can say A and C cannot be on this side of 30. A and C must be on this side of 30. अब D और E में से कोई एक below 30 है, D और E में से कोई एक above 30 है, so that fifth lady has to be B. There is no other possibility. Have you guys got it? समझ गए हैं आप ये बात? Hi Soumya Jain, very good evening. समझ गए हैं तो एक बार फटाफट बताइए मुझे कि yes clear or not, whatever is there. I repeat, A और C को दोनों को साथ होना था, they should be together. If I put both of them together above 30, the other three would be below 30. अब तीन लोग अगर below 30 हो जाएंगे, तो of course उसमें D और E में अलग-अलग कैसे रख पाऊंगा? वो तो हो नहीं सकता. So therefore A and C should be below 30. A and C are below 30, तो एक D और E को अलग-अलग होना है. One of D and E would be coming here. One of D and E would come here. The remaining one lady B must be there, that is above 30. That's the only possibility. Right? Okay. So Aditi Mitra has already given the answer. Very good Aditi, though I don't know the answer, but let's see what is the answer. B and E have the same occupation. So again, now we are talking about occupation. So B and E, they should be together, same occupation. And C and D have different occupations. So again, C and D have different occupations. I feel ye information or ye information exactly similar hai. Iska matlab B and E must be the secretaries. One of C and D would come here. One of C and D would come here. B must be here. B ko fir wahan hona hi padega. There is no other possibility. Bilkul waisa hi jaisa upar kiya hai. Now, what is the question asking you? Of the five women, three men will marry the teacher over 30. Teacher over 30. Oh God, I'm sorry. यहां B नहीं लिखना था, मुझे A लिखना था. मैंने गलती से B लिख दिया. Free man is going to marry the lady who is teacher over 30. Teacher होनी चाहिए और above 30 होनी चाहिए. Above 30 में कौन कौन है? E और D और B. Teacher कौन कौन है? A और C और D. If there is anyone who is common in these two, that means who can be a teacher and above 30, that person can only be D. क्योंकि D यहां भी है, D यहां भी है. D can be the only lady who is above 30 and is a teacher. So therefore, my question is, who will Freeman marry? He would be marrying Deb. So Deb is the correct answer. Julian, no, it has not been done previously. It has been done on GradeUp app, but on YouTube it has been done for the first time. इससे पहले नहीं किया हम लोगों ने. I hope all of you got the answer to this question, though I would say this was slightly on the easier side, looking at the other questions from George Puzzles, George Summers, but definitely beautiful. Definitely worth being in any of these exams because it is purely logical reasoning. You can't say, sir, my mathematics is not good, how can I do these questions? Is any mathematics involved in this? ठीक है, addition, subtraction तक भी involved नहीं है, और तो दूर की बात है. This is a simple, pure simple question that could have been answered by any person with a sound logic. Whether the guy is 10 years old or 60 years old, it does not matter what your education is, उससे कोई लेन देन नहीं इस बात का. And that is the beauty of these questions, what I feel. Okay, yes, you must have done on GradeUp then, है ना? वहाँ पे हम लोगों ने किया हुआ है इससे पहले भी, right? चलिए जी, so this was the first question, guys. Let us move on to the second one. That is puzzle number 5, which is 6 A's. The name of the puzzle is 6 A's. In the question, he said that in the additions above, each letter represents a different digit, right? Each letter represents a different digit. Which digit does A represent? Agar sabhi letters different digits bata rahe hain, then what does A represent? That is what the question is. What is so special about A? A is here as well as here. Wo yahan bhi hai aur wo yahan bhi hai. This is what the question is asking. Okay? Now, look at this question. It says a triple digit number where all three digits are same. Another triple digit number where all three digits are same. Another triple digit number where all three digits are same. They all add up to F, G, H, I. That's a four digit number. And same is happening over here. A triple digit number, triple digit number, triple digit number. Sabke digit same hai. Aur phir se wahi four digit number ban raha hai jo yahan ban raha hai. Theek hai? The point is, in the additions above, each letter, he says, each letter represents a different digit. So A, B, C, F, G, H, I, D, E, these are all distinct digits. Ye sab ke sab alag hai. So how do I proceed with this question? Let us start. First of all, when I talk about A, 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 can I say it is A into 1, 1, 1? I hope you all would agree to this, and please, if you agree, type it there in the chat box. ताकि मुझे भी पता चलता रहे, आप लोग समझ पा रहे हैं इन बातों को. A number like AAA, can I write this as A into 111? For example, a number like 444 can be written as 4 into 111. A number like 666 can be written as 6 into 111. That way. So A is also a digit which I have taken out common. तो number बचा A into 111. And by the same logic, this can be written as B into 111. This can be written as C into 111. And what am I getting at the end? At the end, I am getting, of course, jab teenon ko add karke jo ye number bana hai, can I say this number should be a multiple of 111? Agreed, guys? A multiple of 111 is added into another multiple of 111, which is added into another multiple of 111. तीनों 111 के मल्टीपल्स अगर ऐड होंगे तो कैन आई से देयर सम विल आल्सो बी अ मल्टीपल ऑफ 111. सही बात है ये. द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज दैट दिस मल्टीपल ऑफ 111 इज हैविंग ऑल फोर डिजिट्स डिस्टिंक्ट. एफ जी एच आई, ये चारों डिजिट्स डिस्टिंक्ट हैं. दैट मेक्स इट एन इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट कि एक 111 का मल्टीपल चार डिजिट्स का, और वो भी सारे डिस्टिंक्ट डिजिट्स के साथ, राइट. एंड व्हाट वुड दिस नंबर बी बाय द वे, इट वुड बी ए प्लस बी प्लस सी इंटू 111. ए इंटू 111 प्लस बी इंटू 111 प्लस सी इंटू 111, एड किया 111 आ गया कॉमन, उसके अलावा आपके पास बच गया ए प्लस बी प्लस सी. सो ए प्लस बी प्लस सी इंटू 111 बिकम्स द टोटल नंबर, ये पूरा नंबर बन गया. ओके, सिमिलरली हियर आई कैन से दिस इज ए इंटू 111, आई कैन से इट इज डी इंटू 111, आई कैन से इट इज ई इंटू 111, एंड फाइनली आई एम गेटिंग ए प्लस डी प्लस ई इंटू 111. ओके, सो अदिति सेज आई एम अ बिट वीक एट मैथ्स. इट डजंट मेक ए डिफरेंस अदिति, एटलीस्ट दिस मच वी ऑल कैन डू, है ना, इसका मैथ से कोई लेन देन नहीं है. सौम्याजन, एज आई सेड, इस तरह के क्वेश्चन आपको बहुत सारे एग्जाम्स में मिल सकते हैं. दिस अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट टाइप ऑफ दैट. नॉर्मली दे वुड बी आस्किंग यू इजियर वंस, बट इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस आई एम श्योर यू वुड बी दिस कॉन्फिडेंट. आपको लगेगा यार रीजनिंग का कोई भी क्वेश्चन आ जाए मैं नहीं छोड़ूंगा, बिकॉज वी हैव डन सो मेनी डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चन, उसके बाद एक कॉन्फिडेंस आता है. द इजियर क्वेश्चन आई कैन इजिली मैनेज बिकॉज आई हैव डन दीज डिफिकल्ट वंस एज वेल, राइट. Now the point is, when I say that this FGHI is a multiple of 111, it's a four-digit number, but all four digits are distinct. The first multiple of four digits of 111 is 111 into 10, that is 1110. Which is the next multiple? Of course, isme 111 add kar do. The next multiple is 1221. The next multiple is 1332. The next multiple is 1443. And this shows me, in all these multiples, at least two digits are similar. जबकि हमें चाहिए सभी distinct. We want all of them distinct. अब ये अगर ऐसे ही चलता रहेगा 1443, 155, 166, 177, 188, 199, there would be a stage जब चलते चलते यहाँ पे 1998 आ जाएगा. It would be 1998. उस 1998 में फिर मैं फिर से 111 ऐड करूंगा, आई विल गेट द नेक्स्ट मल्टीपल 111. जरा इसमें ऐड करो, पीछे आएगा 9, फिर आएगा 0, और फिर आएगा 1, और फिर आएगा 2. आई गेट द फर्स्ट मल्टीपल ऑफ 111 जिसकी चारों डिजिट्स डिस्टिंक्ट हैं. ध्यान से देखिए, इजंट इट द फर्स्ट मल्टीपल ऑफ 111 ऑफ फोर डिजिट्स इन विच ऑल फोर डिजिट्स आर डिस्टिंक्ट. मतलब आई डिड नॉट हैव टू चेक ऑल ऑफ देम, इट वॉज वेरी सिंपल कि बार बार 111 ऐड करोगे तो 2 2 3 3 4 4 वगैरह करके आता रहेगा. सो स्ट्रेट अवे मैं 1998 पे गया, 111 ऐड किया, 2109 बन गया. और 2109 तो हमारे काम का है बिकॉज वी नीड अ नंबर विद फोर डिस्टिंक्ट डिजिट्स. बट क्या पता और भी हो आगे, लेट अस चेक. इसमें भी 111 ऐड करते हैं. इफ आई एड 111 इनटू दिस आई वुड बी गेटिंग 22, और उसके बाद कितना आएगा ये 1120. इसमें तो तीन सिमिलर हो गए. फिर से 111 ऐड करो, इट वुड बी 2331. फिर से 1112442. फिर से वही दिक्कत हो गई. अगेन एवरी टाइम दीज टू डिजिट्स आर गेटिंग सिमिलर, ये बार बार फिर से सेम आ रही हैं, राइट. सो देयर फोर आई कैन से एफ जी एच आई कैन बी ओनली 2109. There might be a question कि सर आगे जाके भी तो आ सकता है. See guys, the point is A, B और C maximum कितने हो सकते हैं. One of them can be maximum 9, one can be 8, one can be 7, 9 plus 8, 17 plus 7, 24. किसी भी हालात में मैं 111 into 24 से तो ऊपर इसको ला ही नहीं सकता, और 111 into 24 तो यहां पे 2664 पे आके खत्म हो जाएगा. So anyways, FGHI cannot be above this. So therefore, I will have to stop here. And till now, this is the only number which can satisfy this property. ठीक? मैं एक बार फिर से repeat करता हूँ आप सभी लोगों को. ध्यान से सुनिएगा. A into 111, B into 111, C into 111 add करके बनेगा A plus B plus C into 111. A plus B plus C can be maximum 9 plus 8 plus 7. तीन distinct digits हैं. ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा 9, 8, 7 हो सकती हैं. 9 plus 8 plus 7 is 24. 24 into 111, right? This can be the maximum possible value of this. मैंने क्या किया, 4 digits का पहला मल्टीपल लिया 111 का, विच वॉज 1110. फिर देखा अगला मल्टीपल क्या आएगा, 111 ऐड कर दो, अगला मल्टीपल आएगा, ऐड 111, यू विल गेट अनदर मल्टीपल. इफ यू कीप ऑन डूइंग सो, एवरी नंबर हैज एटलीस्ट 2 digits डिस्टिंक्ट, लेकिन दिस इज द ओनली नंबर विच हैज ऑल डिस्टिंक्ट डिजिट्स, विच इज वॉट वी आर लुकिंग फॉर. हमें सारे डिस्टिंक्ट चाहिए, वो हमें 2109 पे आके मिल रहे हैं. इसका मतलब एफ जी एच आई इज 2109. We have decided this, which is nothing but 111 into 19, which also tells me A plus B plus C is 19 and A plus D plus E is also 19. A B C भी सम, भाई ये भी तो 19 होगा ना, 19 into 111 ये बनेगा 2109. और यहां पे A plus D plus E 19 होगा, because 19 into 111 बनेगा 0, ये 2109, right? एंड बिकॉज एवरी लेटर इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग ए डिस्टिंक्ट डिजिट्स, तो एफ तो ऑलरेडी 2 हो गया, जी इज ऑलरेडी 1, एच इज ऑलरेडी 0 एंड आई इज ऑलरेडी 9. सो दैट मीन्स दीज डिजिट्स कैन बी चोजन फ्रॉम 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. इन्हीं में से चूज कर सकते हैं, बिकॉज 2, 1, 0 and 9 दे हैव ऑलरेडी बीन चोजन. ये तो ऑलरेडी हम लोगों ने एफ जी एच आई इनको मान लिया है, तो आप 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 को लेके चलो कि इन्हीं में से कोई डिजिट्स मैं यहां 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 पुट कर सकता हूं. सो नाउ इट इज जस्ट अ गेस वर्क. इनमें से कोई 3 digits उठाओ जिनका सम 19 बने, और 3 और जिनका सम 19 बने, एंड दे शुड बी हैविंग अ डिजिट इन कॉमन. ट्राई करके देख लो, जैसे अगर मैं 8 + 7 = 15 के साथ तो 4 बनेगा, ठीक है, 8, 7, 4, या फिर 8, 6, 5. देखिए 8 + 7 + 4 + 8 + 6 + 5, दिस गिव्स मी 1 digit विच इज कॉमन, एंड दैट डिजिट कैन ओनली बी ए. सो आर आंसर, क्वेश्चन ए पूछ रहा था विच डिजिट डज लेटर ए रिप्रेजेंट, द लेटर ए रिप्रेजेंट्स 8, सो 8 इज द आंसर. वी डोंट नो वॉट रिप्रेजेंट्स बी सी डी ई, दे ऑल आर इंटरचेंजेबल. B और C को मैं 7 और 4 ले सकता हूं, 4 और 7 ले सकता हूं, 5 और 6 ले सकता हूं, 6 और 5 ले सकता हूं, लेकिन 8 तो मैं सिर्फ A को ही ले सकता हूं. एंड देयर फोर दे आस्क्ड अबाउट A ओनली, कि भैया A कितना होगा, उन्होंने उसी के बारे में पूछा हमसे. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन, नो डाउट्स अबाउट इट. शैल आई मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन गाइस? Any problem to anyone? If you have a doubt, just tell me what doubt you have. And if it is clear, just say clear. मेरे ख्याल से वैसे, though I know it was slightly lengthy question, we had to figure out this number. But just getting this number was the only task for us. And as I said, कि ये questions करते वक्त हम लोग एक approach सीख रहे होते हैं. For example, when I talk about AAA, so how did you reach this conclusion of 111? That was the first initial step. I mean, if I give you this question straight away, many of you probably would not think of it कि यार हमें 111 के मल्टीपल से चेक करना चाहिए. This should have been the right approach. We start putting some digits and we start making them equal to this. हम लोग ऐसा नहीं सोचते हैं, अच्छा 111 का मल्टीपल भी तो चेक किया जा सकता है, because all three are having equal digits. So why shouldn't we start with that? That is one of the approaches that can be important for us, right? ठीक है जी, I hope you all have agreed to this. So I'll move on to the next one now. So here is the next question. Just look at this. Let's read it together, guys. साथ साथ ही पढ़ते हैं. Yes, Rishi, your answer was correct. A is equal to 8. Absolutely fine. He says A, B, and C are three remarkable women, each having some remarkable characteristics. Three remarkable women, each having some remarkable characteristics. Three women are there, A, B, C. Just two are remarkably intelligent. Just two are remarkably beautiful. Just two are remarkably artistic. And just two are remarkably rich. So let me just write it here. कि दो है intelligent, दो है beautiful, दो है artistic और दो है rich. And these all are remarkable. ठीक है, remarkable को एक मिनट के लिए भूल जाते हैं, दिमाग में रखेंगे. Two eyes, two B's, two A's and two R's. This I have to keep in mind. Each has no more than three remarkable characteristics. There are three ladies. There are three ladies. And they have in total 8 characteristics. Do ye, do ye, do ye, do ye. And no one is having more than 3. So can I say the only possibility is one of them will be having 3 characteristics, One of them will be having three characteristics and one of them will be having two characteristics. Is there any other way apart from this? Are you getting this point? There are three ladies. उन थ्री लेडीज में से वो ये कह रहा है कि दो जो हैं, मतलब किसी के पास भी तीन से ज्यादा करेक्टरिस्टिक्स नहीं है. अगर तीन से ज्यादा करेक्टरिस्टिक्स नहीं है, इसका सीधा सीधा मतलब ये हुआ दैट टू ऑफ देम वुड बी हैविंग थ्री करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ईच एंड वन ऑफ देम विल बी हैविंग टू करेक्टरिस्टिक्स. दीज आर दी ओनली पॉसिबिलिटीज, राइट. नेक्स्ट, ऑफ एनेट इट इज ट्रू दैट इफ शी इज रिमार्केबली इंटेलिजेंट शी इज रिमार्केबली रिच. Of B and C, it is true that if she is remarkably beautiful, she is remarkably artistic. And of Annette and Claudia, it is true that if she is remarkably rich, she is remarkably artistic. These are statements of type if A, then B. Agar ye hua, to ye hoga. Theek hai? Aise cases mein, what are the conclusions that we can take out from these statements? Let us just talk about that because that is important for us. Let me give you an example of this. If it rains, the ground gets wet. If it rains, the ground gets wet. अगर बारिश होगी तो ground गीला हो जाएगा. Sir, why should we assume only one? Mohan, I did not get your point. Have we assumed anything only one? I think you are probably talking about something. एक बार जरा मुझे दोबारा बताइए, समझ नहीं पाया मैं. If it rains, the ground gets wet. So if it rains, let's call it a phenomenon A. The ground gets wet, let us call it a phenomenon B. So if it rains, that means if A happens, can we surely say that B will happen? Yes, this is what this statement says. कि भैया अगर बारिश होगी तो मैदान गीला हो जाएगा. That A tends to B. So if it does not rain, let's say call it A bar, it does not rain. So can I say the ground will not be wet? If it does not rain, the ground will not be wet. Can I say so? The answer is no. The ground can still be wet, right? You can put some water on it through some pump or something. Aisa bhi to kiya ja sakta hai na. Agar barish hui to ground geela hoga, but ye zaruri thodi hai ki barish nahi hui to ground geela nahi ho sakta. It can still be wet, so I cannot take out this conclusion from this, right? Next, if ground is wet, can I say it must have rained? If ground is wet, can I say it must have rained? The answer is again no. Barish hogi to ground wet hoga, but main ye thodi keh sakta hu ground wet hua hai to barish se hi hua hoga. It's not necessary that if the ground is wet, it is definitely because of the rain. So you can't say this as well. But if the ground is not wet, can I surely say it did not rain? The answer is yes. If the ground is not wet, the ground is dry, you can surely say it did not rain, because had it rained, the ground would have been wet, right? So if A is tending to B, agar A ke hone se B hota hai, A is the reason for B, A is the cause, B is the effect. The only other conclusion that you can take out of it is that if B does not happen, if the effect is not there, that means A did not happen, that means the cause was not there. Because if the cause would have been there, the effect must have happened. You have to keep this in mind for all the times. I am repeating one last time the final conclusion. If A happens, then B happens. This is given. The only other conclusion is that if B does not happen, A would not have happened. This is the only other conclusion which will be using now. Ab hum log iska use karenge yahan pe. Theek hai? Kaise use karenge? Let me just remove it. Look at the second statement on your board. Theek hai? Yahan pe usne kya likha hua hai second statement ke andar about Annette. So he says, if A, third, of Annette, it is true that if she is remarkably intelligent, she is remarkably rich. So, बात हो रही है एनेट की, बर्नेट की और क्लॉडिया की, बर्निस की, सॉरी. ए के बारे में उसने बोला है इफ शी इज इंटेलिजेंट शी वुड बी रिच. सो अबाउट ए ही कैन से इफ आई दैट टेंड्स टू आर. इफ आई दैट टेंड्स टू आर. द ओनली अदर कंक्लूजन इज इफ शी इज नॉट रिच शी इज नॉट इंटेलिजेंट. अगर वो इंटेलिजेंट है तो वो रिच होंगी. द ओनली अदर कंक्लूजन इज अगर वो रिच नहीं है तो वो इंटेलिजेंट नहीं होंगी. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट. ऑफ बर्निस एंड क्लॉडिया इट इज ट्रू. अब इन दोनों के बारे में क्या बात ट्रू है? इफ शी इज ब्यूटिफुल शी इज आर्टिस्टिक. सो इफ शी इज ब्यूटिफुल शी इज आर्टिस्टिक. द ओनली अदर कंक्लूजन इज इफ शी इज नॉट आर्टिस्टिक शी इज नॉट ब्यूटिफुल. If she is beautiful, she is artistic. If she is not artistic, she is not beautiful. यही है ना, यही दोनों चीजें इनके बारे में बोली हैं. Next, of A and C it is true. अब A और C के बारे में और क्या true है? पहले A की बात कर लेते हैं. If she is rich, she is artistic. If she is rich, she is artistic. The only other conclusion is if she is not artistic, she is not rich. She is not artistic, she is not rich. So about A, I can say. अगर ए इंटेलिजेंट है तो रिच भी होंगी आर्टिस्टिक भी होंगी. और अगर वो आर्टिस्टिक नहीं है तो वो रिच भी नहीं होंगी इंटेलिजेंट भी नहीं होंगी. ये दोनों बातें ट्रू हैं. और ये वाली दूसरे वाली बात क्लॉडिया के लिए भी ट्रू है. दैट इफ शी इज रिमार्केबली रिच शी इज आर्टिस्टिक. सो इफ शी इज रिच शी इज आर्टिस्टिक. द ओनली अदर कंक्लूजन इज इफ शी इज नॉट आर्टिस्टिक शी इज नॉट रिच. इफ शी इज नॉट आर्टिस्टिक शी इज नॉट रिच. If you have understood these statements, now the question would be done pretty fast. अब हम इसको फटाफट कर पाएंगे. कैसे? ध्यान से देखिएगा. We have two people artistic, two people beautiful, two intelligent and two rich. ऐसा करके उसने एक एक करके बताया है. Two of them will be having three traits each. One person will be having two traits. About A, can I say she has to be artistic? क्योंकि अगर ये artistic नहीं है she would not be rich, she would not be intelligent. और artistic भी नहीं है, rich भी नहीं है, intelligent भी नहीं है, तो ये सिर्फ और सिर्फ beautiful रह जाएंगी. Only one trait, और एक अकेला trait तो किसी के पास हो नहीं सकता. So therefore she must be artistic, right? मैं repeat करता हूं. If she is not artistic, she won't be able to rich. If she is not rich, she can't be intelligent. और अगर तीन traits नहीं रहे तो एक single trait आएगा. Single trait, no one is having a single trait. So therefore, she must be artistic. Similarly, let's talk about Claudia. If she is not artistic, she won't be beautiful as well as won't be rich. अगर इनको मैं artistic ना बनाऊं तो ना ये beautiful होंगे ना rich. तो ना artistic रही ना beautiful ना rich, she would be only intelligent. Again a single trait, which again is not possible. So she must be artistic. She must be artistic. Right? अगर ये artistic ना है, तो ये rich भी नहीं होंगी, intelligent भी नहीं होंगी, इसलिए artistic होना जरूरी है. ये artistic नहीं है, तो ये rich भी नहीं होंगी, beautiful भी नहीं होंगी, single trait रह जाएगा, तो इनका भी artistic होना जरूरी है. So both the traits of artistic have gone. She cannot be artistic. And if she cannot be artistic, she won't be beautiful. She neither artistic nor beautiful. She has to be intelligent as well as rich. Because every person should have at least two characteristics. क्योंकि दो लोगों के पास तीन characteristics हैं, एक के पास दो. अगर ये artistic नहीं होंगी तो ये beautiful भी नहीं होंगी. ना artistic है ना beautiful है. That means she is intelligent as well as rich. I hope you are guys are getting this because I'm not seeing any chat on the box. Either you are too indulged into this कि आप बहुत अच्छे समझ रहे हैं या फिर आपको समझ नहीं आ रहा है, ऐसा कुछ हो सकता है. These are slightly difficult ones, I understand that, but I am very sure that you are learning something much much better than what we generally do in our normal classrooms or by normal studying. ये डेफिनेटली आपके LRDI को इंप्रूव कर रहा है. एंड यू आर डेफिनेटली गेटिंग एन एज ओवर मेनी अदर पीपल बाय डूइंग दिस. ओके, सो शी इज इंटेलिजेंट एज वेल एज रिच नाउ. तो एक इंटेलिजेंट वाला ट्रेड भी चला गया है, एक रिच वाला ट्रेड भी चला गया है. वी आर लेफ्ट विद थ्री फोर मोर ट्रेड्स नाउ. इंटेलिजेंट, ब्यूटिफुल, ब्यूटिफुल, रिच. अब ये दो ट्रेड्स ब्यूटिफुल के रह गए, इनको तो और ट्रेड मिलना ही नहीं है. शी हैज गॉट ओनली टू. सो शी मस्ट बी ब्यूटिफुल, she must be beautiful. ये भी दोनों खत्म हो गए. Now one of them would be intelligent and one of them would be rich. One of them would be intelligent, one of them would be rich. Can I make her rich? Can I? See the problem is if she is intelligent, she would also be rich. तो अगर मैं यहां intelligent लिख दूं तो मुझे rich भी यहीं लिखना पड़ेगा, which is not possible according to this. तो यहां पे तो वरना मैं कुछ लिख ही नहीं पाऊंगा ना. देयरफॉर द ओनली पॉसिबिलिटी इज आई विल राइट रिच हियर, आई विल राइट इंटेलिजेंट हियर. गॉट द पॉइंट भाई? अगर ये हमारे पास इंटेलिजेंट हो जाते तो यही रिच भी हो जाते, तो फिर इनके पास दो ही ट्रेट रह जाते, इनके पास दो और उनके पास फोर हो जाते. फोर तो पॉसिबल ही नहीं था. सो देयरफॉर शी कुड बी रिच, क्योंकि ऐसा कहीं नहीं लिखा इफ शी इज रिच शी इज इंटेलिजेंट. लिखा है इफ शी इज इंटेलिजेंट देन शी इज रिच, राइट? शी कैन ओनली बी रिच बट शी कैन नॉट ओनली बी इंटेलिजेंट. इंटेलिजेंट होते ही रिच होना बन जाता. सो शी वुड बी इंटेलिजेंट, शी वुड बी रिच. एंड व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन आस्किंग यू? हु इज नॉट रिमार्केबली रिच? रिच कौन नहीं है? दैट पर्सन इज Claudia. So Claudia is the person who is not remarkably rich, and that is the answer for this question. This is the answer for this question. I'm sure you must have learned a few things today in these three puzzles, especially this part. This is a very important part in many of LRDI questions. बहुत जगह पे आपको काम आता हुआ दिखाई देगा ये. Plus the way of solving the equations in the previous two as well. जैसे हम लोग बात कर रहे थे ट्रिपल ए वाले की, तो उसमें ट्रिपल वन वाला कॉन्सेप्ट, उसके पीछे हम लोगों ने बात की थी द वे वी रिप्रेजेंटेड द डेटा अबव 30 बिलो 30, हाउ डू वी कंक्लूड फ्रॉम दो स्टेटमेंट्स. एक्चुअली दीज आर दी कीज टू सक्सेस ऑफ एलआरडीआई क्वेश्चंस. आप कभी भी एलआरडीआई कभी भी क्वेश्चंस कर रहे होंगे उसमें आप देखेंगे सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट ये है दैट हाउ डू आई कंक्लूड मैक्सिमम इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम ए गिवन स्टेटमेंट. वॉट एवर इन्फॉर्मेशन इज गिवन, हाउ डू आई पुट इट इन ए टेबल और समवेयर सच दैट आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट, आई कैन गेट आउट समथिंग फ्रॉम इट. तो कुछ भी ऐसा करने के लिए बेसिकली इन चीजों की एक प्रैक्टिस बहुत जरूरी हो जाती है. ठीक है, सो दैट्स ऑल गाइस फॉर टुडे. आई होप यू आर लाइकिंग दीज सेशंस, एंड इफ यू आर लाइकिंग देम प्लीज शेयर इट विद मोर एंड मोर पीपल सो दैट अदर पीपल कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन. एज आई सेड, these sessions are important not only from MBA entrance exams perspective, for every other exam as well. And guys, please like the sessions if you are actually finding them good enough, right? Agar aapko lagta hai ki haan kafi badhiya hum log kuch kar rahe hain, so please like it because it gives us motivation as well that yes, we are doing something good for you. Okay, so that's all guys from my side today. And one important information now, rather two. One is this core 99 plus batch, it's a comprehensive course for CAT 2021 that we have just started, right, in grade up. And this all would be covered in that. So there would be live sessions, revision classes, and there's a course for non-CAT exams as well. Plus you will be having a day-wise study plan. All topics would be covered through live classes. And I think 250 plus live classes are there. Quizzes, PDFs, practice questions, GDVAT, PI, mock test. So everything would be covered in this. We call it a comprehensive course because GDVAT, PI, general knowledge, etc., whatever is there, that all would be covered in these courses. Okay. And yes, we have also started with CAT 2022. As we say that it is never too late, it is never too early to start preparing for CAT. So for CAT 2022, we have started a batch right now, right? And all the mentors who are there the CAT course that we are having, they all have scored more than 99 plus in their respective sessions, rather 99.9 plus. Many of them are 100 percentiles too. So you can rest assured that you are in the safe hands, right? Or you can go for a grade up super subscription. Super subscription mein kya hota hai if you take it? So of course you can just go for any of the courses. You don't have to separately purchase those, right? So CAT वगैरह के जितने भी courses हैं सभी के लिए आप eligible हो जाते हैं. And that would include all these things which are written over here. The green card plus the live courses, revision sessions, doubt sessions and everything, guys. Okay? So this is our brilliant faculty team. Probably we can boast of having the best faculty team probably in the nation right now. So you can see their profiles. All people are extremely experienced as well. And if you have any further queries, you can always call up at this number, guys. So that's all, guys. Thank you very much. So see you again tomorrow at 9 p.m. with the next session on this. Another three questions, and I'm sure that you are definitely going to learn a lot tomorrow again, the way you did today and yesterday. Okay, guys, that's all from my side. Good night. Bye-bye.